steel stocks as well. For now, that stock is still holding firm. Siddarth Bhamre is joining us now for some F&O ideas. He's the Director of Alternate Investment and Research at InCred Equities. Siddarth, good morning. You have a couple of interesting buy ideas for this week.
Yeah, Anuj, what we are seeing is that market is heading higher. In fact, last week also we gave large cap buy calls. SCL Tech was a buy, M&M was a buy. Before that also, there were mainly buy calls. FIs are going long. We are seeing Nifty giving breakout after consolidation. First, it was 2 months consolidation, then it was 1 month consolidation. Nifty IT is supporting. Bank Nifty would start supporting. HDFC Bank has given a breakout, but Bank Nifty is yet to move over that 36,300 levels. So all in all, Anuj, it's paying off to be long in this market, and especially in large cap segment. So in today's scenario, we would like to give buy on TCS. TCS has given a price volume breakout after quite some time. In fact, it has been 2 to 3 months or beyond that. There has been consolidation in the range with a slight upward bias. And with other Nifty IT stocks doing well, TCS can give substantial return from current level. So I'm anticipating it to move higher, maybe towards 36,100 to begin with. It's an aggressive target at such higher levels, but stock seems to, moving in that direction. The other stock is a pharma space. Glen Pharma, it has been correcting, but it has been correcting in line with what's happening with some of the pharmaceutical names. You have seen huge formation of short position in most of the other names, but Glen Pharma has been correcting on very low volumes. There has been unwinding of positions rather than forming of short positions. The results have been pretty okay according to Street. So there can be a good bounce back from current levels, and I'm anticipating that stock will go towards 645 levels or so, fixed stoppers of 532 and go long. These are all position trades. And Anuj, before I leave, I just want to comment that people are talking about a high put call ratio being negative for the market. It's not into an overbought zone. According to me, it's not an overbought zone. You are seeing that people are buying put options because they're not believing in this rally. And that's the reason IVs are also high. So more the disbelief, higher the markets would go. And I would suggest to stay long in this market.
Okay, that's something to keep in mind. I think all the bulls would love to...